All right, I think we're live. Let me open this up. Let's jam real quick. So I'm here to give you business guidance. And we are live. And for those who are brave enough, we'll go through your business and I'll show you how to improve it like this. How to 10X your beat business online. I'm just saying the beat business, this applies to all online businesses. But since my audience is primarily producers and artists, we're gonna start with the beat business first and then, you know, apply to everything else. But this can be applied to all online businesses. This is not just for beat businesses. So I wanna preface it with that. Let me turn this down a little bit. Actually, let's crank this up. Let's go. Shout out to Cold Illumination with these loops. His vocal loops are crazy. Vibes going. All right. So nobody's brave enough. So all you guys got to do is hold up. You got to give me your BeatStars or whatever your website is. Actually, don't give me your website. Give me your brand name, because you if you put in your website, YouTube chat will block it. So just give me your brand name and then we'll Google you and we'll see. Oops, sorry. I'm pressing all the buttons. And then we'll see how to improve your business. Seth is here. I was just watching some of your stuff today. Thank you, Seth. Big A. Big A with the big A. That's hilarious. All right, let me refresh, make sure everybody's up in this piece. Went live twice because I forgot to, not forgot, I couldn't do shorter videos earlier. I tried to do my video stuff earlier with you. Didn't have enough time, so now I gotta go live and do it this way. But I want to focus in on your business. I know there's not a lot of people here right now, so I got to wait till people get here. But in the meantime, what we'll do is we'll start with people directly in this chat. So if you give me permission to go to your website, I will show you how to 10X your business very simply. What's up, Seth? We got Big A. We got Horcrux, Iceland tuned in. Bliss. All right. So all you got to do is raise your hand, your virtual hand. Or say me, actually say me. If you want me to go to your website, say me and I'll Google you. No brand yet, but love your content. Thank you, Ramoth. Ramoth Israel. We need a lucky victim. I'm just gonna wait till somebody gets the courage to say me. Then I'll show you guys the secret formula. Till then, we're gonna jam. But I do have a secret formula for you. It's pretty easy. It's three simple steps on how to grow your business 10X. We got Lindo Bull says, thank you for bringing back the If I Produce For a series. Thank you for watching it. I should be thanking you. Thank you. CEO wants me to go to his website. Let's see what it's all about. So I'm going to go to your YouTube first. And hopefully your YouTube links directly to your website. Let's go to your About page. First rule in YouTube, go to your YouTube channel. And then make sure you edit your profile to put your links on your actual YouTube page, because that's the easiest way for people to find out your main website. Do you even have videos? It looks like you don't have videos. What's your brand name, CEO? If you put your website, YouTube won't let it go. You have to just send me your brand name. There's the formula. It comes down to traffic, value exchange, and customer relations. And I'll guide you through this process on how to 10X your business. But I want to tease you a little bit by starting off with a victim. And then we'll get to this formula and how you all can apply it to your business. I just want you to have a good time before Black Friday. I think we all should be taking this time to really sharpen our business before we launch on Black Friday. So that's why I like doing these videos. I like helping you guys advance to that next step. But nobody has the balls to give me their business name. This is interesting. You guys want us to give you money, but you won't give us your business name. That's crazy. Bulg Beats. Okay, we're going to go to Bulg Beats. First, as a customer, I'm going to Google you and see what pops up. Your YouTube pops up before your main website. That's not good. Let me Google BusyWorks Beats, see if it pops up actually. Before I say it's not good, let me make sure my website pops up first. Okay. So see how BusyWorks Beats has my website first, and then the YouTube, and then Instagram and then the other websites. Okay, so you need to figure out why your website is not at the top, especially considering your BeatStars is higher than your own website. So that is a matter of content and SEO stuff that I'm not an expert at, but I would definitely tell you, make sure your website pops up first. DJ Emos says, note to chat, Sound Toys is giving away a freebie. Cool. Gnome says, check out No Mono Vibes. I got you. Okay, so let's go to bulkbeats.com. Let's go to your actual website. Okay, first off, your logo is way too big. I'll give you guys a good example. If you go to walmart.com, and let's see how big Walmart's logo is. It's this tiny, very tiny. Go to apple.com. Let's see how big their logo is. It's even tinier. Probably the most tiny one is the Apple logo. Look how small that is, right? Go to amazon.com. And their logo is just as tiny. Okay, so you guys gotta not make it about you, make it about your customer. So this has no value to me as a customer. Zero value. Actually, negative value. Because I go, wow, this guy's just so into himself. He just wants his name and big lights. That's all he cares about. Let me tell you the psychology about website designers. They want you to buy their website theme. So what they'll do is they'll put up their website stuff. What am I trying to say? They'll put up the themes that have your picture the biggest on the theme. It's because they want you to buy it. They don't care how many sales you get. They're trying to sell their theme. So what's the number one thing people want to see themselves? So they make it all about you and the theme. And as a customer, this adds negative 3,000 value to me because I go, this guy doesn't understand business, and I leave. And the most important real estate online is called above the fold. Okay. So here, your whole beat store is below the fold, meaning I have to scroll to see your beat store. That's the worst real estate to be in because I guarantee your bounce rate is above 90%. I can guarantee you that with a guarantee. With a money back guarantee, I guarantee your bounce rate is at least 95%. And that's because this adds nothing. So if you can, I know you can't, you may not have control over every little detail of your website, but if you can completely get rid of this, this is unnecessary. Take your transparent logo, make it a small bite size, and then try to put it up here with your header somewhere if you can. If not, you don't even need a logo. It's just not useful here. Your logo, as long as it's on the product, you'll be good. Okay, so get rid of this. And let me see. So it looks like you have an embedded beat store. Let's see what tool you're using specifically. Let's see. Looks like you're using, it doesn't say Google, Wix. It says you're using Wix, but then I don't know what you're using for your beat store. I would have to go to a different website, but I'm not going to waste my credits on this site. So whatever beat store you're using, I'm trying to give you advice that like helps you instead of just criticizes you. So the first thing is, again, make the logo super small, put it in the corner. Second thing is with your beat store, if I come to your website and it's just a big catalog of stuff, I'm just going to get confused. I would recommend you have something before getting to the beat store. Like, what are you about? What's your theme? What's your values? Oh, it's the BeatStars embedded. Thank you. Like, what are your values? Let's go back to walmart.com. Now, when I go to walmart.com, they don't show me an entire list of everything they have on their website. Now, to them, they have hundreds of thousands of SKUs. So, of course, their homepage is going to be a little more full because they have millions of products. You don't have millions of products. So, if you look even at walmart.com, it says Black Friday deals for days. This is called an offer. The main issue I see with people who solely rely on their BeatStars and different embeddable players is that they use it as a website and there's no information about anything except the product. So in other words, I would recommend looking at walmart.com and creating little sections on your website that says like, you know, buy two, get one free or something that is like an offer instead of just products. So here's my point though. You go on walmart.com, you see one offer, here's two. This is a slideshow of offers. You have three offers. and it looks like a category section. 5 offers, 6 offers, 7 offers. Before you get to the catalog of stuff, the featured stuff, you have 7 offers. On your website, you have 0, and it goes straight to the catalog. So that's what I would recommend. Just go to walmart.com. You'll get an idea of what an offer is on walmart.com. And it doesn't mean you need to discount your stuff either. Okay, so I'm not going to play your beats because it doesn't. That's beyond the point. Another thing I would suggest about this beat player, I don't know if you have control over this, but the only way for me to get to your beat licensing is to scroll through your entire beat store. So I can imagine if you have 200 beats, this could get so clunky to where it's going to take me forever to even get down to your licensing agreements or even back up to the top to click on where it says licensing agreements. So that's more of a technical thing. Maybe you can't control that, but that's something that you want to, I wouldn't do the full width beat player. I would do like, if you can embed at a smaller size, I would recommend that. If you can, I don't know if that's possible. Okay, let's go to your beat licensing information. Again, I'm assuming that you have some kind of sales channel outside of just telling people to go to your website. So let's go to your YouTube and let's check out your Instagram. Let's check out your marketing for your beats. Okay, so you have 1 million views. Okay, so you're in the Millionaires Club on YouTube. Okay, let's see. I can't sort via the best, so I'm gonna eyeball your videos here. Okay, so you said how you made, so you have a lot of shorts kind of going over how you made certain beats. Here's one simple change you can make. Because I've been doing the YouTube stuff for a while, just to show you, so you know I'm not BSing you. Okay, my shorts have been like the savior of this channel. My channel grew because of shorts. So let me go to my YouTube thing. Okay, let's go to analytics. I think it's under content, I think. Yeah. Okay, so 2.1 million views came from shorts in the last month. In October, 2 million views from shorts. So shorts work, and I would recommend shorts. The only issue is that you're framing it about you. And this goes back to the website. It's about you. This isn't about the customer. It's about you. So instead of, I like what you're doing, like how I made the whatever type beat, but instead of saying how I made relevant, which nobody even knows what that is, maybe put, you know, how to make a, let's go to your website. What's relevant? Let's see what's relevant. Let's see what beat that is. Relevant. Inspired trap beat. Okay, so instead of using the actual title of a song that nobody knows about, use the keywords like inspired trap beat. How to make an inspired trap beat. Something like that. And try to, you can describe how you made it, but put the title to where it benefits other people. Okay? So that's just a simple shift in the way you word things that will help you. And people will care to actually click on it. So I'm just going through your marketing real quick. 3 months ago, it looks like you're pretty consistent. I think you could just be more consistent with your shorts, your content. Because it looks like 10 days, you had about 3 shorts. I do 6 shorts a day. Just to give you context, I do 6 shorts a day minimum. Today, I didn't get to it just because I ran out of time. But 6 shorts a day is my target. So you can do that in a day. You did 3 within 10 days. That's about 1 every 3 days. You need to up your shorts. Okay. So if you need topics, go to Google Trends and click here. Go to the dropdown. Go to where it says trending searches. Go to real-time search trends. Click here and then switch this to entertainment. This will give you topics to talk about. And it doesn't always have to be about music. It could be about whatever these topics are about. So Heidi Klum, Halloween, A Boogie with the Hoodie. Whatever the topic is, you could talk about it in your point of view. It doesn't have to be educational. It could be entertaining. Okay. So I just want you to up your production. Your production is really low. You have a really low production level as far as content goes. And I'm sure this is your number one social traffic source. Maybe Instagram beats your YouTube. Let's see. Okay, you have more followers on Instagram, but let me see your views, even though views aren't the same on Instagram. So you're getting more traction on YouTube. I would just triple down again on the shorts. You can repurpose the shorts to post on Instagram. You can post on YouTube. There's an app called CapCut. Okay, this is going to create auto captions. and it's free and it's very easy to use. Let me see if you use auto captions or not. You don't use captions. So we're listening to this in mute. It automatically goes to your video on mute. I don't know what you're saying. I'm just looking at the lights, which are cool to look at. Okay, you have a cool beard, Ableton, but I don't know what's happening. So I would recommend captions also through CapCut. And also on these videos, a lot of producers think that they have to be in the video. You don't have to be in the video. You don't have to show your face that much because it's not valuable to, as me as a guy, I'm just saying me from a guy's perspective, I don't want to look at another guy. I don't want to look another guy in the eyes. This is not what I want to see. So I would just recommend pulling back the you part of it and making it about the viewer. All right, we could go on for days. Let me see what else. Let me see what other lever you have. So again, you could repurpose your YouTube shorts as Instagram stuff. All you got to do is use CapCut. My buddy Ryan just started some experimental hip hop. Awesome, Ryan. Okay, so let's check out one more thing, which is your pricing. So you have 30 for the MP3, 50 for the Wave. Track outs, get 100, unlimited. I think there's a lot of like variations here. I would, in my opinion, I would simplify this to like three options. Because when it gets into five, it's a lot of reading. And people, if they start comparing, I'm going to be honest with you. Oh, what's up, Chris? I was wondering who said Paul. I'm not used to your logo yet. Like, it didn't even click. I read your comment and it didn't even click that that's you. Holy, I got to get used to your logo. Dang, I forgot what I was saying here. Oh, I would knock this down to three options because you have too many options here, in my opinion. And what was I saying here? Oh, when you get people to reading through the differences between the options, it used to be three options. Yeah, I would go back to three options. Here's what I would recommend. I'm not telling you what to do. I'm just saying. Oh, it's all good. Is because again, my point bulk is a logical point. As a buyer, I would come to your website. I would go, there's five options. Okay, now I got to read the difference between each five. And if I start reading the differences, I'm going to point out fallacies in your terms. What's up, Noah? Swag's here. What's up? And the fallacies in your terms are 5,000 distribution copies, 50,000 streams. These are fallacies because one, as a buyer, you're not going to track this. So this is completely pointless. These are made up numbers that don't mean anything. And as a buyer, we know this. So I just want to save you the headache of wondering why people aren't buying your stuff. It's because this is arbitrary. Nobody's tracking streams. Nobody's even, okay, let's just say in the worst case scenario, let's say I bought your MP3 lease and you're tracking my channel and you somehow figured out that I have more than 50,000 streams. What are you going to do about it? What are you going to do? You're going to tell me to take it down? What if they don't take it down? You're going to send, like, what is the, it's arbitrary. So just, I would just not worry about this. You probably got it from somebody else. It doesn't make sense. Okay, commercial use, that's good to know. Must credit, that's a good term to have. Bulk Beats maintains full rights. I would have a place where it explains what full rights means because to the average person, they don't know what rights are. Let's read your license. Let's see what the heck's inside. Oh, you have a PDF. Okay, so you have a PDF that explains it deeper. Maybe because the contract's a little convoluted. I'll tell you now, an 8-page contract to buy a beat is insane. And if I have to spend 2 hours to read your terms, then I'm going to be scared to buy your beat. So a lot of guys have these terms and things. I just think it's too much. It's too much work. You're scaring people away. Okay, so simplify that. And again, I would simplify your offerings. Knock out these distribution and streaming restrictions. Arbitrary, nobody's, you know, it's pointless. And I would combine your MP3 and your Wave. We know as producers, it does not take more time to render a Wave than it does the MP3. There's no difference. You know, why? That's like saying you can't watch this YouTube video in 1080p unless you're a YouTube premium. You can't watch me clear. You have to watch me blurry until you upgrade YouTube. It's just like that would just diminish the whole YouTube experience. So I would recommend combining your MP3 and your Wave. There's no point to have those separate. It's a false value offer. There's no more value just because it's a Wave. Okay, so I'm trying to help you knock out the bull crap in your offer so that as a buyer, we can come in and we can say, okay, here's what is actually valuable. So those things, you got to figure out something else to give to up your value. If you want to have three options, I would recommend, again, as a synopsis, I would go MP3 and Wave, one offer, $50. I would take away the buy two, get one free thing, because let's say you didn't want to sell two beats and get one free. I would use that occasionally, not use that a lot. And I would have a second option that says maybe, I would have two options, Trackouts and then MP3 or Wave. Keep it simple. Most people are going to buy the MP3 Wave because they just want to do a two-track recording. They're not going to buy the Trackouts unless they need it for, like, you know, placement. And again, all this other stuff is kind of arbitrary. So yeah, that's what I would recommend. And we just got to get you on a better, this looks like a MailChimp. Let me see what this is. Hold up. Mail Munch? What the heck is Mail Munch? Munch. Okay. So I would work on your email page too. It's a lot to work on, but the main takeaways, again, I said a lot. So the main takeaways, make your logo, just delete this whole section right here. This is pointless. It's MailChimp? Okay, cool. All right, because I could tell by that little subscribe button that it was MailChimp. Okay, so make your logo super small, put it in your header. Scroll down, try to make your embed not full width, so when I scroll, I can get to the bottom without having to go through your whole beat store. The third thing is simplify your offers. I would recommend combining your MP3 and your Wave into one offer and just put it at $50. Try to get rid of the buy two get free thing, because that should be, you don't want people to always think you're going to have a sale. Like waves.com, they always have a sale, and people don't, you know, they are just waiting for a sale all the time. What's up, Classy Beats? Here's a very small token of appreciation for all you do. Thank you. I appreciate you. I'm just having fun, really. Trying to go through your guys' businesses and different things. Okay, so MP3 plus Wave, you got that. And then Trackouts could be a higher price. That's more valuable because, then again, they have the multi-tracks, the source project, so to speak. If you can, I would recommend you offer the source project as well and keep a source project for yourself in the case that anybody tries anything funny. But I would also offer the source files, project included. That's a little new age thinking, but that's just how I would do it. Because even people who make like Photoshop logos and stuff, they give you the source files when you buy it. So I would just recommend that. Your license, again, is a little scary. You know, 8-page contract for a beat is like a little overkill. So I would definitely pull that back a little bit. And your MailChimp offer here, I would recommend you have a dedicated page like bulkbeats.com/mixing or something like this. And then have here's my opt-in page. I try to keep my opt-in pages separate from my main website. So if you go to busyworksbeats.com/evolstudio, it's just a page that says, hey guys, you can sign up for this stuff for free. I just need your email in exchange. Okay, so that's a dedicated site you want to build for gathering people's emails. That way, all the energy you're putting out on social media, you can capture it for your email list and then remarket to those same people. Because if you rely on social media, you're not going to keep the energy that you're putting out. Okay, so I feel like I just focused on him a little heavy. How many people do we have here? Who wants to be next? Class E Beats. Should we give Class E Beats a diagnosis? Chat, I'll let you guys vote, since he was kind enough to send in a super chat. Bulk says it's a cheaper option. Yeah, a lot of people, we think that, thank you. We think that people buy on price, but we don't buy on price. We buy on perceived value. And we buy, put it this way. If I believe that the value is higher than the price, that's when I buy. Most people, they lower their price because only if they lower their price will people perceive the value as higher than the price. So as long as your value exceeds the price, people will always buy. It's just that people can't perceive your value if the only thing they can focus on is price, if that makes sense. So you don't want to rely on the price thing all the time. What's up, Besman? I'm slowly reading through the chat. My lease is like 3 years ago. Yeah, hopefully we'll get that message out, how to write your leases out. Who will even read so much? You don't know till you know. Solid says, hey, Busy, appreciate all your work and information. Thank you. False options are like false profits. Goodness. Tarrant is, who wants that smoke? Hero sections are for healthcare sites. Oh, that's what they call them, hero sections. You're right, I forgot that name. Seth is here. What's up, Seth? Official Vision says definitely Class E beats. Got you. 10x your beats, just 10x. Just not always. Content doesn't always solve for the business problem. Okay, let's go to Class E Beats website. We always see his name everywhere. Let's see what his website is up to. All right, so let's see. So see how his YouTube has his stuff linked to his website? Okay, so let's go to your beat store. Thank you, Five Crime. So I guess the common theme for everybody on BeatStars is to have this banner, beat player, leasing license agreement, contact button, and that's it. I don't know why everybody follows this format. I'm not sure why. Let's figure out what you're using to build your website. Let's check. You're using BeatStars. I'm assuming that's the player. What's Printful? Is that the t-shirts? I don't know what you use to build your website, but I can figure out a different way. I just can't quickly see what it is. But regardless, I'm assuming this is BeatStars. It's a pro page. Okay. So let's, before we even get to your actual webpage, let's go to the starting point of all traffic online, which is your social media content. So I'm assuming YouTube or Instagram is your best channel. So on Instagram, you have 36,000. Let's go to your Reels, because Reels are basically the only traffic source right now. Let's be honest. Pictures aren't cutting it. Okay, so you have, when was this reel? August 12th. It is November, sir. Your last reel was on August 12th. You are committing sin number one, which is not doing enough. Yeah, you just broke the cardinal sin. As cardinal sin number one. Okay, which channel are you most active on? Are you active on Twitter, or what's your most active channel? And again, I'm going to go through these guys, and then I'll give you that secret formula for how to actually grow your business 10x. Here's what it looks like. You can screenshot. I'll give you a couple minutes to screenshot. But I'm going to explain what this chart is and how to use it. YouTube. Okay, YouTube is his number one channel. Let's see. Let's look at his stats. Okay, YouTube is your number one channel. You have 700,000 views on YouTube. My Tube Buddy thing turned off, but it used to give me stats and stuff. Let me just kind of scroll to see how many videos you put up. Okay, 1 month ago. So let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 11, 12, 13, 14. So 14 times 4 is, what's that math? 14 times 4. Okay, so he has 56 videos he's published in the last 2 months. So let's divide that by 60. About a video a day. Here's the issue. And I'm not telling you what's going to get views and what's not going to get views. I'll just tell you why you're stagnant. Is because most people are, okay, how can I explain this? The same way we went to Bulg Beats website, and as soon as I went to his website, it was logo, product. There was no offer. There was no anything explaining anything. It was just, you're here. Here's stuff to buy. Here's my email list. So the same thing as your YouTube. We come to your YouTube, and it's just stuff to buy. There's no context. There's no value. There's no, okay. I didn't mean value. I meant this a different way. The value association is what I was going to say, but darn, I don't have that chart. Let me turn off my screen for like 3 seconds. I'm going to show you guys another chart that you have to understand. Okay, we'll come back to this formula chart, but let me go to this one. Hold up a second. Let me see if I can open up multiple. Oh, I can. Okay, y'all can't see this, but I have multiple tabs open, which makes it so much easier. I think. Okay, here we go. Okay, we're good to rock. Okay, now you can see my screen again. Thank you, everybody, for hopping in, first of all. Thank you, Woofer Ultra. So one of the principles you guys got to realize early before later is most people mix up the words promotion, marketing, advertising, and sales. Those are four separate functions. Okay, so I want you to completely shatter any definition you have of promotion, marketing, sales, or advertising. A lot of people tend to merge those words together. They're completely different things. So if you think of it as an XY axis, X meaning the horizontal, Y meaning the vertical axis. Okay, the X axis represents time. You're from Omaha, Nebraska. Shout out to you. So if the X axis is time, whatever I do in a certain amount of time is called promotion. There's no defined income. The only defined utility of promotion is to... I get tongue twisted. The only defined utility of promotion, the number one goal and the only goal of promotion is to increase your reach, your views, and to be seen by a lot of people. The goal of promotion is not to convert into sales. It's not to raise your value, and it's not to do anything else, but literally increase what are called impressions. And impressions in the marketing world are similar to seeds. If everybody's mind is like a garden, our subconscious mind, the mind that acts even when we don't know we're acting, is like a garden. And impressions are like seeds. So if your number one goal in promotion is to be seen, all you're doing is throwing seeds everywhere. You're just throwing a bunch of seeds everywhere. I learned from Hermes Trismegistus in his book called The Pymander. He said every tree comes from a seed, but every seed doesn't turn into a tree. In other words, if I'm thinking about it like advertising, just because I'm seen by somebody doesn't mean that they'll buy something from me. And you have to use that principle in business because you have to understand where you're spending your time, focus, and money. Hermes Trismegistus. I named my first plugin after him. Trismegistus. I think I spelled that right. I probably spelled it wrong. Probably the E should be an I or something like that. But that's generally how you spell the name. So my point is, during promotion, throw out seeds. It's even a biblical principle. Like Jesus said, like you could throw your seed out, it could land on a hard rock, which means it's not going to have the soil it needs to grow properly, or it could land in the actual good soil where it's going to grow up and be a great plant. Or the seed could land in the soil, grow up to be a great plant, and then the enemy comes by and has a weed that sucks it of its life. To put it in business terms, I can make a YouTube video for promotion purposes, again, making seeds. One of the seeds could land on a hater. A hater hates me, and he's like, yo, this guy doesn't know what he's talking about, even though all the information is valid. He's the rock. He could care less. He's not going to receive me. Then I have a loyal fan who loves me. They receive all my videos. They watch them, all the videos. That's the fertile soil, because that fertile soil will take the seed, the information, the content, and the value that I just gave them, and they'll return it back through reciprocity, and they'll exchange value with me over time. That's your customer, your defined customer. And then you have a person who wants to be your customer, but they get persuaded by the enemy and you lose out on a customer because the enemy persuaded your customer. So that's how you apply that stuff to business. I'm showing you this chart to show you what you don't have on your YouTube channel is the marketing. And what I mean by marketing is not just doing content. Marketing is increasing your perceived value. And you do this, the brain works off of associations. So if I say the word ice cream, let's do a quick, I did this before. How many people are here? We have a lot of people here. Okay, so we're going to get a good poll here. So when I say the words ice cream, what two words do you guys think of? What two words do you think of? And that's to everybody in the chat, because this is an important exercise for Class E-Beats to understand this principle. So as you guys put in your responses in the YouTube chat, again, when I say the words ice cream, what two words do you think of? Now, I'll define what marketing and what that means. So marketing is increasing your perceived value. The goal of marketing is to only increase your perceived value. Remember, I told you before, to Bulk Beats, it's not that you need to lower your price all the time. It's that value needs to exceed price in order for people to make an exchange. I'll say that one more time because that sounds very like high level. Value needs to be greater than the price in order for people to exchange that value with you. Okay, because they need to feel like they're turning their dollar into something greater. And the whole cripstick, the whole point of marketing is to elevate that value mark. So whatever price you're asking for, people have zero resistance. Okay. So the goal of marketing is to associate. The brain works off of associations. We have something called mirror neurons, but that's part of how people do this. That's through demonstration. But we also have the power of association. So here's the example of the power of association. So I asked the chat, I said, what two words come to your mind when I say the words ice cream? I Am Jet says sweet. It's his sound says Ben and Jerry's. Mai says mint chocolate. Tuners Beats is ice cream. Classy Beats is cone and cold. Tony says chocolate and vanilla. Bulk says cone and scoop. Lil Joe says cream vanilla. Grumblebee says chocolate sandwich. What in the world? Oh, like ice cream sandwich. Waydu says paint job. Ice cream paint job. That's hilarious. Mint chocolate, fat, cold sweet, lick crunch, sugar milk. Okay, so I just said the simple word aching teeth and cold. So I just said the simple word ice cream, but you can see the chat associated the word ice cream to all these different words. And the reason they associate the word ice cream to all those different words is because they had the most impressions of that word upon that symbol. Our subconscious mind can only understand symbols. And we work off the power of association. Literally, our brain, my brain is like Google. So if I say ice cream to my brain goes, it pulls up the first search because the brain works off of the path of least resistance. So it goes to its first little response, and the first response says mint chocolate or mint. And then the next neuron that's the biggest says chocolate. They fire first and they respond back. So my point is a simple word like ice cream, you can get all these different definitions because that's how the brain works. It associates different symbols and words to different words to different symbols. So now we know how the brain works. In short, we want people who look up Class E Beats to think about things that are of high value. That's why you see rappers always standing next to the Rolls Royce, the Rolex. These are called wealth signals. I want you guys to look up the term wealth signals. Let me see if I can find some examples. How to use wealth signals to spot wealthy prospects. All right, let's click on this. This seems like a sugar website or something. Wealth indicators, how to use wealth signals to spot wealthy prospects. Their profession. Okay, that makes sense. Like if you're a doctor, chances are you make a lot of money. Foundation affiliations. If you're in like some of the top fraternities in the world, chances are you have a network of people and chances are you have a greater chance of success. That makes sense. Size of their charitable gifts. If you can give $1 million, you're probably a millionaire. Real estate holdings. If you have 10 properties, chances are you have some money. So these are called wealth indicators. Now, those aren't the greatest. That's not the greatest list of wealth signals. Your watch is a wealth signal, by the way. Your car is a wealth signal. If I'm riding in a Ferrari, it's very hard to mirror or mimic a Ferrari. So that's called a wealth signal because it can't be faked. And any man that has excess income to waste on a car, you know, the opposite gender believes that, that since they have so many excess resources, they must have excess for a child. It all goes back to childbearing, basically. So whenever you see somebody next to a Rolls Royce and a Rolex watch, you know, what's the jeweler's name? There's like a famous jeweler everybody goes to, Eliante or whatever his name is. You know, all these different things, they're increasing their perceived social status and value. Okay, so what people are buying when they buy from Class E Beats is not just the beat. They're buying social status because now they could say, oh, I have a Class E Beats beat. It means something. It's like having a Bape hoodie. Not a lot of people can have the bait putty. Everybody wants what's in low supply and high demand. How do you increase your demand? You create desire by letting other people know that they desire you. Let me say that slower. Desire is created when other people see other people desiring something. So you need to have a lot of what's called social proof. And I'm kind of going, like, giving you a lot of angles here. I don't want to go too spread. My point, Classy, is that for your content, is that, oh, that's a video I want to comment on too, by the way. Is for your content, you want to make sure you're giving context as to what your value is along with your product. Because you're giving us product, but you're not giving us the social status part. You're giving us the what you do, but you're not giving us the, hey, I'm in this fraternity. I am associated with this person. I rock with these people. You know, you're not giving that part to it. And that's the branding part that nobody talks about. Those are called intangibles, intangible values. Okay, so yeah, I don't need to go into the rest, but basically I just wanted to describe the difference between promotion, marketing is increasing your value, and the y-axis is value in this case. X-axis is time. And advertising is finding a floor of perceived value, the consensus of value of something. And then sales is the ending transaction. And this ends the cycle of communication with the customer for the first cycle, I'll say. Yeah, so where you can 10X, Classy, is basically instead of putting up your product, you have tons of product, but let me sort your most popular. Wow, 1 month ago, you got 30,000 on one. So notice you're limited because, how can I explain this? When you compete product against product, it's very, like, it's similar to Bog Beats competing on price. He was like, buy two beats, get one free, you know, $50, $30. If that's the only thing people have to compare two different things, they're going to go with the lowest price thing. In other words, you're fighting with your product and not with your intangibles. You need to fight with your intangible values. Everybody can make a tight beat, but everybody can't smile in the camera and talk about different topics or talk about the problems that your audience has as an artist, like finding the right producers. You got to tap into the problem areas to get people's attention. Of course, they'll check out your beats. You don't have to separate that into a different channel either, like most people tell you. You don't have to separate that stuff. You just need to focus on the intangibles, because right now you're playing a product fight, and that's why your channel's stagnating. Okay, because it's about supply and demand, and there's too much supply of what you're doing. But note, there's not enough supply of Classy Beats opinion on how an artist can do X, Y, and Z, or whoever your audience is. You need to solve their problems and their biggest frustrations. Okay, so that's what I would recommend. That's why you're stuck where you are. I have a question, and I think I'm slightly unique situation. I started producing in 2020. I make copyright-free stuff with the goal to boost Spotify. How am I doing? We're going to get to you next because I don't understand that question. Okay, so again, coming to your website, same stuff, big banner, but this one has an offer. Okay, so Bog Beats, this would be an offer as opposed to a logo. Buy two, get one free. Is this a Black Friday deal or what? Simply add three beats to your cart. I'm trying to think. I bought beats off YouTube before. I'm trying to think, did I ever care about the buy one, get one free thing? I don't know if I ever cared about that. No, it's the ceiling is because you're focusing on your skill. And that's not the problem. You could probably have skills. I would hit play, but I don't want it to trigger your beat audio thing. You have skill. Again, you're fighting. How can I make this make like more sense? I'm trying to really think. Let me think for like 3 seconds. I guess the example I had didn't make sense. I was going to make a Call of Duty example, but that doesn't make sense. But again, you're fighting the wrong battle is all I'm saying. You're fighting the complete wrong battle. And all right, I'll just leave it at that because I can go on and on and on. But I would just need to know but does this deal have to be here? Is it always here? For all the deals that I run, usually they're limited time. Because people figure, okay, if I've seen this 2 months ago, it's always buy two, get one free. And then they lower your perceived value. You want stuff to be exclusive and limited time to create urgency. Okay, so one recommendation I would just have in general for anybody with a beat store is to have it to where it's segmented based on like the artist or genre. I don't know if you could do that here. Can you do that? If I click on this, what does it do? Okay, see, I didn't even know it does that. Because having everything here, it's just not curated enough. So that's the tricky part about beat stores, is the curation part. Most people leave out. Let's see what services you have. Vocal mixing and mastering. Now, if your mixing and mastering is more than the beat, then that's sketchy. Your mixing and mastering is $150, and your beat prices are... The least is ideal for... Okay, I like how you explain why they should get the lease. This is a better example of how you should do your offers. For beginners who don't want to make changes to the beat, you want to quickly record. I like how you made it super simple for them. They don't need to know what a wave is and all these hard terms. Track outs, cool. Okay, exclusive. All right, I kind of like how you have your exclusive, but I kind of don't at the same time. Because what I would experiment with, not that it matters right now, it's not going to make the biggest difference. I would increase this by $50 every week and see what happens to your sales. Because if the exclusive is only 4 times the price of, you know, the popular option, I would go, why not? Like, this person's clearly not making a lot of money, because, you know, selling 4 copies of a beat shouldn't be hard. So why is the exclusive only 4 times the price? So you got to be careful with this, because this is such a nuanced thing, but it's more about the value intangible thing. Because now I think that nobody buys your beats, and that this is like, you want people to... What I'm saying is, you want to make it look like people already desire you. That, again, desire is created when other people perceive desire in something. So something you can also add to your website is a social proof element, showing people that other people bought from you, like a testimonial section, or like a video testimonial section, or social media clippings or something where people say, thank you, Classy Beats, for this beat. Because this would confuse me, this right here, this disconnect. And I wouldn't believe that you sell these. Okay, so not that it's a huge thing, but that's what I would look into. Okay, must credit. Blah, blah. Okay, I'm glad you're not into all the like minutia that everybody else is into. Only thing that's confusing is the buy two, get one free, buy five, get 10 free. It's just, this is a little confusing because I don't know how that works. But okay, so going back to your services, $150 for vocal mix, song and master is the same price. So the question is, I would go, okay, as an artist, why would I just get my vocals mix? Oh, it says vocal mix and master. But it says song mix and master. So what's the difference between a song mix and master and a vocal mix and master? That's a little confusing. Because I would want, instead of me paying for my vocal, I would pay for the whole song. It's the same price. Instagram marketing request quote. Like in this case, I wanted a price, but there's no price. We just got to work on your services. This looks a little confusing. Song mix and master. Seems like you have 3 copies of each. I don't know why. I don't know if that's a glitch or what. Okay, you got merch. Instead of selling merch, I would have pictures of your merch on real people and not these little mannequin models. Before you sell anything, I would have your real merch on some
30 seconds remaining.
My bad. On an influencer or something like that. Because just having merch on your website, it doesn't increase your value. Okay. So it's not increasing your value. It just looks random. And then your contact form, videos. There are no videos. You need content. Oh, there are videos. They just didn't load. Okay. And again, this isn't content, it's just product. So the main thing I'm seeing with Classy Beats, he's thinking that product is content. That's not the case. Like the ShamWow guy is squeezing the ShamWow. What's his name? Billy something. or no, he's the different guy. ShamWow's this dude. Okay. So ShamWow, now what Classy Beats is doing, because physical products make more sense. Classy Beats is saying he's a factory. He's making thousands of ShamWows every month. But the problem is the ShamWows are just sitting on the shelves and nobody's coming into the store to buy them. There's just thousands of ShamWows. He has an infinite supply of ShamWows. Great product, but there's nobody demonstrating the product. You need a ShamWow guy for your business. You need a guy who can demonstrate your product, who can show the features of your product and the benefits of using it to associate ShamWow. You remember in the was it ShamWow or OxiClean? I think it was ShamWow, where he compared the toughness of a ShamWow with like something really tough. Or no, it was the OxiClean guy. What's his name? Billy something. Billy Mays? Okay, yeah. Billy Mays had this like spray stuff. It was like, you could spray it on a boat and it would seal it up. I forget what it was called. Spray sealant. Let me see if I can find it. What is that stuff called? Flex Seal? Is that what it's called? I think it was called Flex Seal. Let's just say it was called Flex Tape. Oh, Flex Tape. Thank you. Flex Seal. All right, wait, I need to find the video because he's on a boat. He's specifically on a boat. Yeah, Flex Tape, I think. Yeah, Flex Tape. Thank you. Okay, so he's demonstrating, even if this isn't him, this is a good example. So Classy Beats is really good at making Flex Tape. Oh, he says song is vocals and the beat. Vocals are just the vocal mix. Definitely could be better though. Yeah, as an artist, I would go, what's the point of just the vocals? I want the whole thing mixed. But that's just arbitrary information. I'm just letting you know from a customer point of view. Okay, so I don't know if you guys can see it, but Billy Mays or whoever this is holding a tape that can pick up a bar, what are those called? A plate, like a 45-pound plate. And I remember in my brain, it's this guy. I swore it was Billy Mays. It was some spray. It was called like, he sprayed a boat one time. It wasn't tape. It was something else. I'm surprised I can't find it. But there was clippings, and I don't know why I can't find it now. But basically, he was on a boat, and there was a hole in the boat. And then Billy Mays like sprayed this hole in the boat with some black tar-looking stuff, and then it sealed the hole in the boat, and now the boat can keep, you know, going wherever it was going. So we, as a people, when you have a good product like this, you got to demonstrate the benefits, because people aren't buying your thing. They're buying an outcome. And that's the thing that's so hard to understand as a salesman. They're not worried about us. That's why when I saw Bulk Beats' logo, I'm like, we could care less about that person. We care about us when we're buying stuff. So people's number one goal when they're shopping with us is to have an intent. This is the desire of all humans, is to have an intent and immediately get to results. That's the desire of humans. Isn't that God's ability to have an idea and it immediately manifests? That's what we want to do as humans. We want to have an image or an idea and we want to bring it into reality with the least friction. So your goal for your product is to show people how do they go from their intent or their desire to their results using your thing. That's what you need with your content. You need to show people how to do that. And that's what a lot of people are missing. They're just showing like their thing, but they're not showing people how that thing will take them from here to here. Okay, so that's what you're missing in your entire brand. It's like showing people how your stuff can take them to where they're trying to go. And good that your product does good on its own, but we want to make sure you're getting, you know, 10x. So I want your goal. Let me see how many videos you produced. I think it was 46. It was like a video a day. So instead of doing product videos every day, I want you to do a YouTube short every day, at least three. I do six. So, I mean, if anybody sets the standard, it's me. I do six shorts a day. Just giving value to your audience, showing them how to go from, you know, stuck in their parents' extra bedroom to where you can get studio time for free. Or, you know, what else is a frustration of an artist? not getting a clear recording before, here's a plugin you could do to give you cleaner recordings. So I don't have to mix it as much. I can make it sound better rather than just trying to fix how terrible it sounds. You know, you got to think about real problems that your customer would have. Demonstrate that every day, and I guarantee people will start associating the problem solving with you, and that's how you increase your intangible value. And again, you could repurpose that to Reels. You could do it on TikTok. The app is called CapCut. It doesn't leave any watermarks or anything. So that way you can repost it everywhere. So yeah, that's your biggest hump in your business right now, is not enough intangible stuff. And I can go deeper into your Instagram link, but I don't want to, it's not a hot seat. I just wanted to use a good example. Thank you, Class E-Beats, for being willing to do that with me. Who else is up in this piece? I'm clicking all the wrong tabs. We got Facebookers in here. Andrew's here, says, yo, I linked that. You linked that? You like that? You think the hardest part of producing is sound selection, mixing, or composition? Sound selection is the hardest part, in my opinion. OG says, chinabrowninstrumentals.com. Let's go to his website. Oh, wait, we were supposed to go to somebody on YouTube. I completely forgot. All right, so if you want to be next. Oh, Small Fry says, love the way you explain everything in shorts. Thank you. Appreciate you donating. Thank you. Class E-Beat sent in $100. He glitched the money machine. Glitch in the Matrix. Funny enough, that $99.99 is a wealth signal. You just showed people that you have $99.99 to spend on a random comment on YouTube, which increases your perceived value. You get it. That was, if you Googled it, that was a wealth signal. And not to make this sound like crazy, but like if you go to a club, an adult club, that's why guys love throwing money. They want to be the best money thrower. Why? Because it's social status. That's why they do it. All right, let's go to China. And thank you, Classy Beats. I appreciate you. Let's go to China Brown Instrumentals. Also, Classy, since you're so good with everybody behind the scenes, whose show were you just on? Was it Gummy Beats, or you were just on somebody's Instagram? What can we do with Classy Beats? Trying to think of like a crossover content type thing. Let me think for 3 seconds. Class E Beats. How can we cross over? Give me 10 seconds to think of something cool. I would say if it's beat related, let me think. What I could do is maybe we find, we use one of your beats for like a little quick contest thing. We get somebody to record from our Discord. And then we use your beat in the video, their vocal. And then we show people like how to mix the vocal over top your beats. So they're hearing your beat in context. And they're hearing how to mix their vocals to your beat, which is demonstrating your beat. And then we can send people, if you want the full mixing of the full song, they can go to your services tab. Oh, lifestyle, that's who it was. I knew it was something to do with smiling. Lifestyle is always cheesing the camera. if you're willing to do that, I'll do that. I'll find somebody in our Discord. They could do the vocal, and then you could send over one of the beats, and then I'll show people how to mix the vocal in, Or we might not even need them. Let me think. I'll think about it. I gotta think about it. But that's how it would work. Wait, I lost my tab. Oh, chinabrowninstrumentals.com. All right, let's see. China, this better not be an adult website. Okay, China Brown Instrumentals. Okay, we have the same issue going on. Super huge logo that nobody cares about. So again, make your logo very tiny. If you go to walmart.com, their logo is very, very small. And put it in the header if you can. It must be a page thing, a page builder thing. Okay. Buy one, get three. I don't know if this is like a trend, but we don't need... When I come to your website, I need to feel like the buy two, get one free thing is a limited time thing. Like, I think, what's that store called? Darn, it's such a cheesy store, and it's blanking my mind right now. What is that store? Top Apparel Stores. All right, that's local. 17. All right. There is, what is that brand called? It's gonna drive me insane until I remember. Macy's. Darn it. There's a really cheesy, Old Navy, I think it is. Old Navy, that's what it is. Okay, so Old Navy, I think every around Thanksgiving and Christmas time, they have a BOGO sale. Old Navy BOGO sale. Old Navy BOGO sale. Okay, and it's specifically called BOGO. I didn't even know what BOGO stood for until I realized what it meant. Sale date. Okay, so it's not very clear when it happens, but I know it happens around Christmas time. So the point is, you should save your like 50% off sales. Basically, I'm trying to say so much without saying a lot. A buy one, get one is basically a 50% off sale. Okay, that's exactly what it is. You're buying two things for the price of one. It's 50% off. It's a cool way to word 50% off. You don't want to use 50% off throughout the whole year. I would say maximum two times a year, during the summer and then for Black Friday or Christmas. If you do more than that, people are going to perceive that you'll always go on sale and they won't buy for those months until you have the sale. So you're hurting yourself for like 2 to 3 months by having too many 50% off sales. So that's why we spread them out so far. People, you know, if they really want something, are they going to wait 6 months or are they going to wait 2 months for it to get a 50% off? They'll rather wait 2 months instead of 6 months. So that's why I use it two times a year. Okay, so the buy one, get one thing, I would recommend using that less. I like how this embedded player is a lot smaller. Doesn't eat up the whole website. However, again, when I come to your website, there's no offer. It's just product. You know, imagine walking into Walmart. It had no signs, no carts, no rails, no nothing. They just had stuff stacked up on the floor. Just piles of stuff. You'd be like, what is going on here? Am I in a third world country? So the same thing with your website. You want to make sure people go in, they get their cart, they know this is the Subway, you know, the attached Subway to the Walmart. They know, you know, this is the kids section, this is the men's section, this is the TV section. They know this is the higher price stuff in the back, this is the lower price stuff in the middle, this is the cheap tripwire stuff in the front, the impulse buys. They know what deals you're running when you walk through. You see certain signs that say buy two t-shirts, get one free, whatever it is. So like you got to have an offer when people come to your website. And subscribe to our YouTube. You'll never miss a beat. All right. I guess I'm assuming you refresh this every now and again. But again, you got to China Brown with this one. You want to make sure that you separate your product from your content. And we're having the same problem here, which is everything's the same. You know, you might as well put this beat in your player. It's just, you know, what's the point of playing the same thing out here in a video? It doesn't add anything. Okay. And then your email list could be a lot better. I would recommend for you guys to learn more about emails, I would recommend HubSpot email certification. Because you got to know what an opt-in page is and like the point of email. So look up the HubSpot email certification. I'm certified. I just downloaded my certification. Let me show you guys real quick. Hold up. I am certified. Hold on, let me open this up. So I'm certified in email marketing. I'm going to be certified in a lot of stuff. I'm going to get my certifications in a lot of things. But I'm officially certified in email marketing according to the HubSpot programs. And I would recommend the same thing because you need to understand how powerful email is. Also, if you want to be certified in music production, I just reminded myself, we now have the Music Producer Professional, which is a brand new certification program. So if you go to premium.busyworksbeats.com, you can look further into it. But basically, you can get certified in becoming a real music producer. We go over 5 main modules: sampling, arrangement, sound selection, melodies, and beat making. Because again, this is as a music producer. Now, music producers don't always need to know mixing, so that's why we separated it out. But the course curriculum, you can literally see everything in this course. This specific sample course, I should say. So it's sampling beginner to advanced. Then we have actual hard exams. They're not easy. You can't just hack your way through these exams. Then you have more content, and then you have another exam to really get you tested. So in order to get certified, you have to pass all these tests with flying colors to be certified. And yes, I made sure those tests were extremely difficult, because we don't want everybody just saying they're certified. We don't, that would make it look cheap, okay? So that is the new music producer professional program. And we have payment options. You can do 10 at 49 and 5 at 99. And if you wish to discontinue, that's fine. You just won't be certified. But if you ever need to, whatever, cancel at any time, you just won't get your certification though. So that's that. Music producer professional. Just wanted to tell you guys, because I got my certifications. Click here to get certified. How you spell certified? 2 I's. Okay, so there's that. But yeah, I'm seeing the same problems with these beats sites. You know, there's missing a lot of key DNA for sales. And you guys are overlooking a lot of opportunities. So hopefully you're making up for it in the content ballpark. All right. So who else wants to get a diagnosis? A diagnosis. Thank you, OG Steve, for your website. Sean Bico. What's up? Rigo says, yo, can you compose a 90s house beat? We're not doing that right now. David says, what's up? The Never Ending Network. Thank you. Honestly, I'm not happy with your productivity, busy. You haven't evolved, says Leo. Nutna says, ice and cream. Oh, back in the ice cream example. A lot of people want me to put my paid content on YouTube for free, and I just am not doing that. Certain things have to be valued. You know, if you're chasing like a really, you know, worthy woman, let's say, if she gets with everybody that encounters her, are you really going to think she's that worthy anymore? You're not judging her. It's just, it's a social thing. It's like, dang, if everybody can get you, are you really that valuable? And the answer is no. And so to keep my stuff valuable, I keep it separated from the YouTube stuff. It's even a biblical principle. You got to separate the wheat from the chaff. You got to segment. You can't have everything out there. All right. So yeah, that was Class E Beats came through with the big bags. Feel a little wealth signal on you. He put it in practice that fast. Okay, so here's the secret formula that you guys have been waiting for. I'll just give you the formula. Since everybody's beat store is kind of looking the same, I'll just give you the formula and I'll explain how this all works. So take a screenshot. This is the part where you can start recording on your phone if you want to record stuff. I don't sell anything. I just connect my content creators. That's all my stuff is copyright free. I just connect with content creators. Well, if you're not selling anything, then what's the point? I want to talk to people who are selling stuff. I want to make some people some money. Okay. So here's the formula. It comes down to 3 pillars in business. You have the traffic pillar. This is all about getting people's attention. The second pillar is the value exchange. And the third pillar is called customer relations. So the first pillar, again, is all about getting people's attention. And that's it. There's no, you're not thinking about the result. The only result you want is to get people's attention. I almost stumbled on my words. The only point of traffic is to get people's attention. Similar to our chart here with the difference between promotion, marketing, and advertising and sales, content is about promotion. It's about throwing out seeds. Your only goal is to be seen. That is the only goal with content. Marketing is a little bit different. Now, with traffic, you have main sources like social media, which covers Instagram, YouTube, Facebook, TikTok, Twitter, Pinterest, And then you have other sources of traffic, which people don't really use, but paid ads. You could do offline and online paid ads. You could do billboards. You could do magazines. You could do joint ventures, partnerships, product placement. A lot of you guys aren't in that realm yet. So social media is your only tool for now. That's fine. Now, most of you didn't know about this app called CapCut. It basically creates auto captions. And my videos ever since I used CapCut have like 10x'd because I showed Bulk Beats when we went to his YouTube page and we watched his short. YouTube sends me to his short on mute. So if he's talking to the camera, I have no idea what he's talking about. And I'm missing all that dialogue. So CapCut makes it to where you can create auto captions in like under 10 seconds and just export your video and it's good to go and it's free. So I would highly recommend that because again, now when I go to your page and it's on mute, I can still read what you're saying, even though the audio is off. And that's very powerful because when you read words, whose voice do you hear in your head? Chances are you hear your voice in your head. And who do you believe the most? Yourself. So when you read things, you read it in your voice and you convince yourself more properly because you're so used to your voice already in your head. And it goes back to the amount of impressions that you've had. Who do you trust the most? Yourself. Why? Because you're with yourself all of the time. You see yourself all the time. What's up, Roger? And so you've created the most impressions on your subconscious mind. So that's why you trust yourself the most. I have many voices in my head. That's funny. Okay, so Instagram to YouTube is your biggest lever point. A lot of people don't realize you could just repost your Instagram stuff to YouTube. As long as it doesn't have a watermark for the YouTube short program, you will be able to monetize it soon. I think in 2023, they're going to allow you to monetize on YouTube shorts. Not, is it going to be groundbreaking monetization? Probably not, but it's going to be something. Okay, so you guys should do that. Questions, any thoughts on Twitter, video changes? Preview, you have plans, huh? Any thoughts on Twitter video changes? $1 per view. You got to reword that breakneck. I don't know what that even means. If you're talking about ads or you're talking about content. Okay, so traffic, again, most of you guys can repurpose your Instagram to YouTube shorts. It doesn't take any more time. Now, the trick is I used to edit in Instagram, download the preview, but they turned it off. They turned the audio off now. So I used to edit in Instagram, you know, do all the titlings and stuff, download the draft. It wouldn't have any watermarks on it. And then I would repost it everywhere. But Instagram got smart and they stopped. They muted the audio. So now when you download in your draft, at least from the last time I did it, it mutes the audio. So now you can't just download the draft without the watermark and repost it. So I've used this app called CapCut. It's way better anyway. Has auto captions and it looks cooler. So use CapCut. I said that like 8 times. And then export that and post to YouTube, post Instagram, copy your title, just paste it each time, post to TikTok, and then post to Twitter. That's my routine. I do 6 videos a day, like on my average day, 6 shorts a day. Once you have your content, the goal is just get people's attention. Now we have to convert their attention to the next step. And the way we do that is by having a call to action. Now, most people, they just make a video, call it a day. Thank you, Elon. Most people just make a video and call it a day. Now, let me see if I can pull up my Instagram real quick. I just want to see. I can't even remember which video. Oh, it's making me log in. Darn it. Well, one of my Instagram videos, I forget which one it is. One of my reels, on every reel, because there's like a time restraint. Oh, here's the one thing I forgot. If you guys are repurposing from Instagram to YouTube, make sure the video is under 1 minute because YouTube has a limit of 1 minute. Thank you. And Instagram has a limit of 1 minute and 30. TikTok has a limit of, I think, 3 minutes or 10 minutes. But for YouTube, it's still at that 1 minute mark. So whatever videos you do, to get them to all platforms, it has to be 1 minute or under. That way you can post it to YouTube, TikTok, Instagram, et cetera, et cetera. From Israel, thank you. Content within 2 weeks, Twitter will enable a new video monetization feature. Oh, I didn't know that. Okay, that's cool. $10 per view is insane. like to get 1,000 views, I'm down $10,000. That's pretty intense. That's not a good deal. If it's a dollar per view, that's not a good deal. Maybe like 3 cents a view. That sounds a little more affordable. Not a dollar a view. But that's cool to know. Thank you for the intel. So our goal is to take people's attention that we're grabbing through different means. There's different means to get people's attention. In short, you want to trigger people's curiosity. That's the main thing people don't tap into, is people's curiosity. Use words like, which whatever is better? Question mark. Use question marks. Use this. You won't believe this. Like that. You won't believe this. Dot, dot, dot. Use a lot of asterisk stuff that's like becoming popular now. Like new ShamWow feature opens up the sky. I don't know. I just made that up. Also, what else is like a hyperbolic type title? And celebrity. You always want to try to use celebrity. Celebrity's like the number one click getter. Celebrity names and things. Now, I try to refrain from doing content about people who passed. I just never did it. So that's where I would, that's my own personal taste though. But what was I saying? Okay, so those are some things you could use to make your content have more curiosity. And on top of your content having curiosity, you also want to try pattern interruption and shocking people. But you don't want to shock them and be annoying. You want to shock them into new truth. You want to shake their logical foundations. That sounds easy, but you have to know what you're doing when you get into that. So what you do is you present a polar opposite take, but then you justify it using common thoughts. And that's the tricky part. It's kind of like, you know, the polarities I could think of is like sympathy for the devil. Going, you know, I mean, if somebody had to make an argument for the devil, you know, the polar opposite of a God figure, they would go, well, don't you need the opposite of God to have a God? Don't you need down to have up? Don't you need hot to have cold? Okay, that's a way to shock people into a new truth, shaking their logical foundations, presenting that polar opposite, but justifying using a common thought. So what I just did with that example is I justified, quote unquote, the devil's existence, but in the frame of glorifying a God figure. So I didn't shame God. I didn't degrade God's name. I never bashed God. I said, doesn't the opposite have to exist for this opposite to exist? So that's how, but you have to do that in less religious-y ways. You have to figure out how to do that with your content and the stuff that you cover. So that's just a really extreme example of how to do that. So that's how you get people's attention. You need to really dig into people's remember, young grasshopper. I don't even know that. That's a person. Remember, young grasshopper. Desire is created when other people see other people desiring something. In other words, when you trigger curiosity and people go walking down that rabbit hole, they go, what's down that rabbit hole? I want to see. And they all go down that rabbit hole. MC Shoddy did this, John says, I'm late, but I get it. Dope. Thank you. Okay, so that's the number one goal with content. Trigger curiosity. Get people down your rabbit hole. And shock them to where they try to, you know, understand their core beliefs. I don't want to dig so deep down that because there's a lot of ways to get people's attention. Okay, so once you have their attention, most people run out of time, which is understandable. So every video, I don't have this in every video, but, you know, in the good videos, I'll have what's called a call to action. And a call to action is at the end of this video, I want to tell people to do something. Okay, so here's the formula. You want to introduce curiosity in the beginning of your content. And again, let me show my credentials just in the case that people just got here and they don't believe me or anything. So I appreciate everybody who's still here. Give me like a second to load up. So on Instagram, let me load up my Instagram real quick. Da-da-da-da-da. All right, Instagram. On Instagram, let me find my impressions real quick. Here it is. Oh, you know what I could do? I could screenshot and I'll send it to my computer. Okay. Oops, where'd it go? Okay, so in the meantime, as I'm sending this to my computer, wait, somebody tagged me in something? Oh, branded content. I don't know who that is. Okay, so on YouTube, in the last, I kind of pulled back from YouTube because I was finishing the product. So my views went down a little bit. But let's look at the last 90 days. Okay, so I want to start with credentials because I just want you to know I'm not BSing you right now when I give you this formula. And you can go back and see which videos do the best in my catalog and then compare it against. I don't know why this is taking forever. So in the last 90 days, we did 7 million views. And if you look at the source of the views, it's mostly shorts. So I got 5 million views from shorts and 1.8 from regular videos. So shorts are clearly taking over the YouTube landscape because there's low supply but high demand. Okay. And if you look at even where my views come from, the browse features are like the home page, basically. Shorts feed is like its own thing. And then YouTube search is like search based. Okay. So that's all YouTube traffic. And where'd my Instagram thing go? Hold up. Give me a sec. I got to pull up the Instagram picture. Here it is. Okay, so on Instagram we had, and I just took this at 9:07, it's 9:08 right now. So on Instagram, I didn't even post a lot on Instagram, but everybody's sharing this like Lil Nas video that I did, Lil Nas X. He's, for some reason, his picture is just viral. I don't know. Like the two videos that I did with Lil Nas X, he went viral both times. I don't know what it is about his face. People love it, apparently. But there's a million accounts reached in the last 30 days on Instagram, and 989,000 were people who weren't following me. That's the whole goal of social media, is to get in front of people who are not following you, and then you want to convince them to follow you. And I have a formula for doing this. Swish Major sent in a bag. Thank you. He says, Swish Major in the building. I couldn't join your live because I'm in the middle of my law exam. So my man is in law school. Shout out to you. Good luck. All right, so I'm showing you these numbers not to be all whatever. It's just the advice I'm about to give you for this formula has brought me this far, thus far. So if you can take it further, you know, cheers to you. Okay, so here's the formula. You have curiosity. You have to start with something that you have to assume that whoever's watching your stuff has never seen you before. And you have to speak as if you're 8 years old or younger. Because most people don't have a common language of the average college graduate. So you have to not dumb it down, but you have to use more common language. Okay? There's a lot of English words that I don't know because I don't use them every day. Same thing with everybody else. You may use some English words that you use every day, like John. If I'm not from Philly, I would not know what a John was. I know what a John is because I'm from Philly or from the Philadelphia area. But if I wasn't from Philly, and I just use that like every Philadelphia person says, yo, this John, crazy. They'd be like, what are you talking about? What is a John? Even though John is like an elementary word, because it's not a common word, people don't understand what it is. So when you're making this content and stuff, you want to use a language that's so common. Here's the way you test it is when you go into your video editor and you do the auto captions. If the auto caption picks the wrong word, that's how you know you're not pronunciating and you're using complicated words. Because if it picks the wrong words, then you know if an AI can't tell you what the word is, then how will a person who can barely understand your dialect understand? Philly Joe. Seymour is here, what's up? So the number one thing that's stirred up views for my content is curiosity. Starting with a question. Here's the biggest secret of this. Music, dark side of the music industry. Like everything's a mystery for my brand. And it works because it taps into people's curiosity. Then you want to create what's called an open loop. The easiest way you can create an open loop in your content is, here's the formula for example. My Lil Nas X video is doing I mean, he's not even like the focus of the video. It's just like the secrets of the music industry. And let me see how many views it has right now. It has, give me a second. Thank you to everybody who's sharing that video, by the way. There's so many people sharing it, like every 10 minutes. It's crazy. It has 790,000 views on it. And what was I saying? Oh, the formula is start with curiosity. A question is the easiest way. You usually start with a frustration. So it's like, if you're a blank, 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 and you suffer from this, here's a video for you. But that's not a curiosity statement. Curiosity would be, have you ever wondered about the dark side of the music industry? Here are the 10 reasons why every artist fails in 10 years or something. I don't know. Just make something up, but have facts. Okay. So that's curiosity. Then you move into what's called an open loop. An open loop would be, an example of an open loop would be, before I tell you all 10, I want to tell you the number one failed artist, Ice JJ Fish, and then go into comedy, something like this. So what I'm saying is that you make a promise in the beginning of your video and tie that in with curiosity. Then you move into an open loop. And an example of an open loop is, but before I show you X, Y, and Z, first I blah, 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 whatever the phrase, like whatever you're getting into. So you have curiosity, you get people's attention, they're hooked. Then you have an open loop, which keeps people watching until the end. And that's what most people lack, is a reason to watch till the end. Okay. Then you have your content. This is where you build a bond. And this is where you build trust. Then you deliver on your promise, and then you do the big reveal, it's called. Okay, now every video won't be cinematic like this, but that's the mega formula for how I do content. Oh, thank you. Yeah, the Stealing Loops one. Instead of covering Palace and the Gun Boy situation, I go, people are talking about the idea and concept of stealing loops. That's the conversation. So let me address that as opposed to the people involved. And that's how I spun that into my own ecosystem like that. But that's the formula of how to make content. So once you have your content made, you will start getting traffic. The more consistent you are, again, my standard is 6 short videos a day. So if you're doing anything less than me, then don't expect any of these results. If you're not willing to do 6 videos a day, you might as well just not even listen to anything I'm saying right here. Okay, so the next step is called the call to action. So once I have people's attention, and I have them hooked, I need to give them directions for the next step. Have you ever been into something new, like a completely different work industry or something like this, or like a shop you've never been into, or like a location you've never been into, and it's not clear where to go? You're like, okay, I'm here, but like, what's the next step? Do we go this way? Do we go that way? Do we go up that hill? You know, where do we go? And you need to give people a direction to the next step. CG is here. They've been doing that forever. And that's how most producers remake famous melodies and slap drill and trap on it. CG came to verify. You want to smoke with that statement. Then you want to give them the next step. Shout out to CG. I appreciate you. Okay, so what is the next step after they watch that video? They're triggered with curiosity. You have them hooked. You build trust. And then you deliver on the promise, then you move them into the next step. An easy way to do this is to create a series. So a lot of my videos, you'll see part one, you know, like Curtis King exposed, part one. The word exposed is for curiosity's purposes. I almost put the other word. Exposed always works. That's another way. That's another hyperbolic way to do stuff. Okay, but whenever you have a part one, part two, people assume that it's a series and it's like, oh, there's more. There's a cliffhanger. So you want to lead people into that next step. Call to action, it's called. But usually a call to action is going to lead people to a destination where you want them to go. Now, I would recommend you send people to what's called an email opt-in page. Oh, thank you, CG. I'm going to screenshot that. Put it on Instagram. Thank you. I appreciate you. Okay, so usually you want to send people to your website where they can opt in with their email, because again, most of you guys are good at getting people's attention, but you're not good at keeping it. So when you get their view on YouTube, they're satisfied. Now send them somewhere. If you guys have ever gone to Disney World, you'll know this is the Disney World formula. They'll bring you to a place where thousands of people are. Okay. You're in the gates. They basically trap you in there the way it's designed. And then you see all this social proof happening. Then you have to wait in a long line and you get to see all the VIP people walking by, skipping that long line. So you're like, dang, I need to be what the VIP people are doing, because they see the benefits of having that social status. So then they want to upgrade to VIP because it cuts down on a frustration of people, which is time, which again, going all the way back to the beginning of this video, I said, what do people want? They want to have an intention and they want to create a result instantaneously. Whenever there's friction or anything that gets in the way of that, they get frustrated. Your job is to create things that remove those obstacles out of the way of people having an idea and it coming into fruition. You need to have something that removes those stones out of the way. So if we're using Disney World, for example, I'm in line. The people in the way are the problem. So I can remove this problem by buying a VIP pass where there are no people. And that's how they get people to justify buying those VIP tickets. So with Disney World, what I learned is when you're in line and you go through the ride, as soon as you're done being happy in the ride, they hit you with the gift store. They hit you with the gift store right after you leave that ride. Why? Because they want you to be happy. And once you're happy, you're more likely to open your wallet and create reciprocity that way. You could look at Disney World. It's worked for years and years and years. The Disney World formula. We'll call it the Disney World formula. Does title matter on TikTok? If you have a title that goes all the way throughout the video, if that makes sense, like if your title only shows up for like 3 seconds and disappears, then I can't say titles matter. But I will say titles do matter for people who can visually see your short without clicking on it. Like not the scroll into shorts, but the ones where you can visually see them before you click on them. YouTube has that type of system. And those thumbnails, I'm noticing, do work with specific titles built into the video thumbnail. Yes, I'll say titles, they do matter. They do matter. You can't just put like something random and expect people to click. At least on YouTube. I don't know about TikTok, but I know YouTube, yes, titles do matter. Tags don't matter on shorts, because all my shorts literally have like no tags on them. Okay, so I don't want to go too off the veer real quick. So basically, again, I don't want to veer off too much. So the traffic that you get, once you create that formula that I just gave you, hopefully you screenshotted it with the curiosity, the open loop. You want to build the content to build a bond. You want to deliver on the promise and have the big reveal. Once you have that, you create a call to action. You want to send people over to what's called an opt-in page. On the opt-in page, this is where you get people's emails, email addresses. And sometimes people ask for text message. I don't like asking for the text number at this point in time. I feel like that's my marketing style. I just don't like that. But you could try it. I think people use text also because it's harder to fake a text number than it is an email. So I get that. But I rarely ask for text. Maybe that's my business's next level's text, but text has always cost me a lot of money. And every time I receive a text, like a marketing text, I'm like, why are they sending me this? It just seems out of place, but that's just me. So that's my story. So my point is, you want to take people off of social media, move them onto an opt-in page. Once you have them on the opt-in page, your goal is to get their email, and then you move them into what's called an email sequence through what's called an email autoresponder. So you guys will probably use MailChimp because they have free options here. So if you go to pricing, where's it at? They have a free, does anybody know how to remove malware? I feel like there's malware in my Google Chrome and I don't know how to get it off. If anybody knows, email info@busyworksbeats.com, because that clearly was not supposed to happen, that little in-between thing. But I don't know how to undo whatever I clicked on. Okay, so anyway, MailChimp has a free option where you can send 2,500 emails for free to 500 people. So in short, if you had a list of 500 folks on your email list, yeah, I'll leave it up. If you had 500 people on your email list, then you can email them 5 times a month and then it maxes out. So that's a lot of people you can email for free. Okay, so I would recommend getting that. The only thing with MailChimp, I mean, they may have upgraded, but over time, you may want to move into other systems, but to each his own. Malware bytes. Okay, so content, email exchange is the second step. Once you have them in your email sequence, you can do what's called, sky highs here. Yeah, AWeber's one. You can do what's called back-end sequencing. I use Kajabi for that, for emailing. I knew Kajabi for like membership websites. I didn't know they did emails. Now, keep in mind, AWeber and all these guys have different sending reputations. Okay, so AWeber is not the same as MailChimp, is not the same as ActiveCampaign, is not the same as HubSpot. You know, they all have a different sending reputation, it's called. So just because all these websites have free this and free that doesn't mean that your email will actually end up in the inbox of the recipient, because it's based on their sending reputation. Okay, based on canned spam and all that type of stuff. Because if a lot of people are reporting that they're getting spam from a certain sender, then, you know, the ISPs are going to block that person, that company. Okay. We used to do live events, but the pandemic happened and I stopped doing them. Thrill Beats, maybe soon. I just don't feel like doing any live events. I'm just over it. Okay, so that's what I would recommend for the email thing. Okay, so once you have their email, then you can move them into, I recommend you move them into your Discord as soon as possible. We have 36 something thousand. Let me see how many people we have on our Discord. Let me count real quick. How many people we have in the Discord? So the point of Discord is to keep people around, and it's the network effect. You know, if you have 1,000 people in your Discord, let me see, server settings. If you have 1,000 people in your Discord, chances are the one of those 1,000 people is going to be more valuable. It's going to be valuable to the other 999. Did I say that right? Basically, everybody becomes valuable to everybody, and it's more than you. It becomes bigger than you. So now it's not just based on what BusyWorks Beats creates. It's based on what everybody creates all the time. And the network effect moves pretty fast. So we have 36,700 people in our Discord. And every time somebody joins the Discord, they add value to somebody else. And it keeps people around. Oh, Thrill Beats is in the Discord. So it keeps people around. And that's what you want to do. An email list, you know, they'll only receive messages when you're awake or when you're... Oh, the Royce's 2X, is that you? Oh, no, that's not. That's a different... So I remember Royce's helped us set up some of the beginning portions of it. What's I saying here? So Discord allows for a lot of things. Live streaming, content discovery, free downloads. We have loops in here, beat battles, song feedback, tips and tricks. What else? Giveaways every now and again. So it's a lot. You know, it's... Yeah, this is live. What's up, Tyrone? So there's a lot of... A lot of sticky stuff. A lot of things to keep people around in the Discord, is my point. An email list is great for broadcasting people, but does it keep people around? It doesn't have that glue element. Okay, so again, you have social media, you use curiosity and all these things to get people's attention, move them over to your email opt-in page. Then you gather their email so you can continue to talk to them. Imagine going to a party. Social media is a big party. It's just thousands of people at this party, but it's only for one night. So you can meet thousands of people at the party, but you're going to forget thousands of people at the party the next day. Why? Because you didn't get their number in your phone or their social media contact or any way to follow up with them. So your goal at a party is meet lots of people and then get their contact information. So that's what this, you know, step one going to step two. Going from getting people's attention to converting that over to your email opt-in list. It's the same thing as getting somebody's number at a party. Now, you need to show that person at the party that you're actually valuable to them. What's up, Godly? Thank you. And Bob Dragon's here. So you want to show that person at the party that you're valuable to them. And you want to give value before you ask anything. So the secret Facebook formula is if you scroll down Facebook. Now, I don't get on Facebook anymore, so it may have changed. But when I was used to be on the personal side of Facebook, scroll down. Every fourth post you see will be a sponsored post. So the formula is three pieces of content and then a sponsored ad. So what I'm saying is when you make your content and you move people to your email address, email opt-in, you get their email address, and then you move into your email, your backend email system, you want to hit them with three emails of value before you ask for anything. Okay, before you ask for them to buy anything or support anything or do anything for you, you need to have three things that you can do for them before you even start asking people for anything. And that's the formula I've been using. So on the back end, it's every four emails, I'll have something where people could buy something. I use the Facebook formula. I figured if it worked for a $1 trillion freaking company, chances are it'll work for you. It'll work for you. Okay, so once you have them out of the email, you want to also get them in your Discord. And the reason you want them in Discord is because YouTube and all these other platforms, Instagram included, you even saw my Instagram stats. Where did that picture go? I think I closed it out. But, you know, we had 1 million reach on my Instagram, but 989,000 of those people that saw the videos were not followers. What does that mean? That means that only, what's 10,000 out of 1 million? That's not even 1%. That's like only 0.1% of my audience watched my stuff. I have 100,000 followers on Instagram, and only 0.1%, am I saying that right? No, 0.1% of the total view count came from my actual audience. 0.1%. And the problem with that is I can have all these followers, but if they're not seeing the content, it doesn't matter. And my point is you need to have a system to where they see every time that you post. So that's what Discord is for. You can kind of get around Instagram not sending out notifications to everybody, because the reason they do that is for a very strategic reason, but I don't want to get into the weeds about it. But they just don't send your notifications to everybody. So you need an outside source to remind people that you actually posted something of value. Thank you, Tyrone. He saw the YouTube course. Sick. You're going to be killing it if you apply the stuff. And here's, what was I saying? Here's the Discord, and you can notify your people to YouTube videos, your latest Instagram posts, anything of value for them, you can notify them. And it kind of, it's the fertilizer for your content. So if you ever feel stuck, it's probably because your notifications aren't going to everybody, or you need to re-engage your audience. And you could do that easily with a Discord. So what I'm showing you is you can create an infinite machine of social flow. As long as you make good content, this whole machine works automatically. You make the content, convert a certain amount of people to your email page, they sign up to the email list, you get them into your free Discord, you send them links back to your content, and over and over and over. So that creates an infinite machine. Now, the question is, where does the money come from? And that's where, you know, maybe a different stream we can go over how to monetize all this type of stuff. Because this is a higher level training, but we talk about one-time offers. We talk about low-ticket offers. We talk about upsells, you know, how to monetize your email strategically to where you're not burning out your list. Different business models, recurring revenue models. You know, what do you sell? Is it software? Is it sounds? Is it courses? Is it services? Coaching? What is the thing that you sell? Merchandise? And then figuring out how to integrate this strategically to where it doesn't cost you money to run this whole machine. That's where I think we'll do a higher level stream. If people support this stream, then I'll do another high level one. But sometimes if I talk too high level, it just goes over people's heads, and it's just a waste of time because I'm talking to the wrong audience. Okay, so I'll leave it here. I'm getting a little tired, but I appreciate everybody for being here. Again, Classy Beats came through to sponsor today's stream. Tyrone came in, got the YouTube course. I'll leave this up, and I just want to say thanks. CG came through. Who else sent the super chat? Swish Major, thank you. And Small Fries. Awesome. Thank you, guys. Okay, peace out. Oh, before you leave, actually, if you want to get certified in music production, specifically music production, just go to premium. Is my call to action. Here's an example. Actually, no, I'm not even going to try to talk about the premium stuff. Let's give you something for free as a thank you. So if you go to premium.busyworksbeats.com, there's a free YouTube course, because I was tired of people trying to sell you YouTube courses. Hold a free YouTube course. So just go to premium.busyworksbeats.com. And where's the YouTube course? Oh, it's not on the front page. No wonder people are probably confused. Darn it. Okay, so I got to put it on the front page. But basically, if you click on the premium, premium deluxe tab, I'll just link this in the YouTube. Basically, click on the premium deluxe tab. By the time you see this, hopefully it'll be on the front page. I didn't realize it was tucked away. But here's a free YouTube course. It's a limited time free course. The reason I'm doing this is because I saw some other people trying to sell you like lies about YouTube, and I just don't like that. So I was like, let me just give you the real deal about YouTube. Okay, so that's for free. My experience in YouTube is, I just gotta show credentials real quick before I head out, so people don't think I'm BSing them real quick. But shorts have been the greatest fertilizer for my business on YouTube. So I just want you guys to maximize it while it's hot, because everything is not hot all the time. Like, every part of the market is not going to be hot all the time. So here are my YouTube stats or whatever. You can see shorts pulled us up to a new peak, the highest amount of traffic we've ever gotten in any point in history. Okay. So if I just keep my foot on the pedal, you know, it'll go back up. But I took a break to focus on product. I'm going to come back with more shorts. And yeah, here's all the stats, blah, blah, blah. I think the total reach is like 1 billion or something. 1 billion impressions. It might not say it here, but yeah, it's 1 billion impressions or something wild like that. Okay. So without further ado, I'm going to head up out of here. I appreciate everybody for hopping in. I don't know how to get to the impressions data, so I don't feel like looking around. Shorts. They're going to monetize shorts in 2023. I would say use shorts to bring people back to your catalog. As long as you have a nice catalog of YouTube videos, it'll be fine. All right, I don't want to like overly talk about YouTube because that's not what this video is about. But I just wanted to give you guys an opportunity to get a free course as my call to action. All right, so hopefully you apply everything. And if you guys watch this live stream enough, maybe I'll do part two where I go into more higher level type